Tonight, where we dig beyond the headlines. Tonight, we're discussing President Tinubu's renewed hope agenda and ministerial expectations with a constitutional lawyer and political analyst, Tunji Abayomi. All right, Doctor, let's shift our focus to President Tinubu's ministerial list. What are your expectations?
Well, we can only judge him from past performances. We expect that he will pick the best and the brightest, using the words of John Kennedy. We expect that he will pick quite a number of youths that can lead us into the future. The world is changing very rapidly. Future. So it should be an admixture, because one single thinking cannot resolve the complex issues of Nigeria, in my view. But I think he has sufficient freedom, having been a governor of a very complex state like Lagos.
So we have 5 more days to the constitutional deadline for the president to appoint ministers. What's your advice to him at this point?
My advice to him is that to think very, very deeply, and then he should write down his goals. What do I want to achieve as the head of this government? What does my government intend to achieve? And then decide, are these people capable, competent, able, strong enough in mind, in intellect, physically, for this great voyage? And then he should take them one by one, look at their attributes, their capacity, their ability, their strength, and their weaknesses, and then decide each of them. Because the expectation of Nigeria is very strong and very serious. And the people of Nigeria want a different nation. That's what they expect from President Bola Ahmed Tinubu. And having gone through the crucible, my expectation and my prayer is that he will not fail. I believe he will not fail.
So many people predicted that the 2023 presidential election would be very close and competitive. What were the surprises that, in your view, the election threw up?
It wasn't close. The gap between the winner and the second is almost 2 million. The gap between the second place and the third place is almost 2 million. As you can say, that kind of election is close. No, it wasn't close.
Are you there with us, Doctor?
Yes, I'm
so
with
what were
you.
The surprises?
I'm saying the election.
Okay, what were the surprises that
well, the surprises,
view?
The surprises, in my view, is the power of youths. And I'm happy over that, because now government cannot take the youth of Nigeria for granted. I mean, we have a situation where there was division virtually in every home. Some of my children were not following me. They were attacking me for taking a position in support of my party, attacking my party in my own house. That's the effervescence, the charge, the interest of the people of Nigeria. And you can see the number of what future elections will continue to follow this line.
So people say the election has made us far more divided as a people. Do you agree?
Every election creates division. America is still dealing with division from the last election. I mean, we are talking of it's 4 years now. Trump has gone to court 60 times. 60 times he's been in court because of the past election. another 11.
All right. So apart from fully implementing the federal character principle, what other steps can be taken to unite our fractured nation?
The greatest means of uniting us is to empower us economically. Poverty, for example, knows no ethnicity. Poverty knows no religion. The same thing with wealth. Anybody who has ability to pay for medical health, to eat, we will have to take a look at the structure of the nation. I'm not talking about restructuring. People talk about restructuring. But how do you restructure a nation that does not have an adequate structure? The adequate structure is the agreement by the peoples of Nigeria on the type of government they want for the peoples of Nigeria.
All right. So, Dr. Abayomi, the verdict of the Presidential Election Petitions Tribunal is being awaited. Do you see the legal battle leading to a rerun?
No. There's no case. There are three principal issues that were raised by the opposition. Let me take them briefly to tell you that any elementary legal mind will understand that it's an exercise in futility. For us to say Tinubu wasn't qualified, to hang your case on certain forfeiture. Well, the Constitution talks of conviction largely as disqualification. You cannot talk of conviction without a charge, a plea, and a trial. All criminal forfeitures follow conviction. All criminal forfeitures universally. So, for example, a drug baron can pay me money for my services as a lawyer. Drug money for my services as a lawyer. And the law will go after that money because it's bad money. But I'm not a bad person because I wasn't involved in his business. So, separate bad money from good people. You can still attach that bad money. Now, when I'm a bad person, you will charge me to court. I will take a plea. I would be tried and I would be convicted, and then forfeiture would.